What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you guys so much for clicking on this video. Wow, what a week I've had. I haven't been this sick since I can't even tell you. So whatever's going around, make sure you take care of yourself because it got me and it knocked me out for a complete week. But I'm on the uptick now. I'm doing this intro for this video. This video is going to be stuff that didn't make it to my other videos because unfortunately I didn't get to get out this week and go thrifting. So really cool finds. Some of these things just didn't fit in the things I was doing and editing for past videos, but this is gonna be about an 8-minute video of some cool things that I have found along the way over the last couple months. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and make sure you're taking your medications, your vitamin C's, get lots of water, get lots of rest. Whew, 'tis the season. All right, guys, let's get right into it. So I guess this is one of the, per se, worst Spider-Man movies ever. I'd beg to disagree. This whole franchise of the Tobey Maguire ones, I love. A wonderful single-stitched 1984 Los Angeles Summer Games tee. Love finding vintage Los Angeles shirts. The graphic on this thing is so rad. Look at this. Just amazing. So happy I found this. Here we have Levi's 505. Now, these are the orange tab. If you don't know about the orange tab, do yourself a favor, do some research. These bad boys do catch a good amount of money online. These are shorts. They're a little distressed. They're worn in to perfection, so I grabbed them. $2.99. Why not? Here's another super old single stitched. Gilroy, California, the garlic capital of the world. Lovely, cool shirt. Had to grab it. Looked brand new, like it's never worn. Here's a really nice high fashion Tommy piece. Look at that gold zipper. Look at that, so cool. I put it on, it fits too perfect. I'm not gonna sell it, unfortunately. It's gonna go in the collection. It fits so good, feels so good. Damn, that's a keeper. This piece right here, I had never heard of this brand before. It looked a little interesting because on the inside, you see it's all embroidered on the inside stuff. So I looked it up. These jackets go upwards to $400 to $500. It's an Italian brand, GCDS. Never heard of them. I copped this for like $9. Could be an easy flip for $100, $200. Now here's another center check Nike. This is a windbreaker style. I'm not really sure what they go for online because I know that the center check hoodies are going for a good amount. I grabbed this just because I have the center check. It's vintage. It looks really awesome. It's really clean. This could be a good flip. I'm not really sure what the price would be for this. It's something I have to do some more research on, but I definitely grabbed it. Here we have a Wii U bundle. This bundle had 3 Smash Bros. GameCube controllers and a Mario and Luigi Wiimotes, you know, the whole setup for it, which was really nice. Now, the problem with this is they wanted $100.
that's a little steep for me to resell it, because they go for at least $200 used online, because Wii U wasn't, you know, the most popular Nintendo, so now everybody wants to collect them because now they don't make them anymore. So $100 was a little steep, especially because that console was really scratched up. The actual like handheld screen device was not. But for $100, a little steep, they wouldn't move on it. So I wasn't willing to put in $100 to not really make, you know, a good amount of money. So I passed on it, but still really cool find. So this is a great come up. I came up on two golf tees. This one particular is the Teller the Creator X Golf. This one I believe has the tour dates on the back. Yes, it does. I paid $1.99 for this one, but I also grabbed the anti golf tee as well, which I paid $1.99 for. The black one, $30. The white one, $40. Good come ups.